Love me some seagulls.
Hello, people of Earth.
People of Earth.
Yes.
As the sun pulls away from the shore and our ship slowly sinks in the west, we have managed to secure our lifeboat once again. Here on the lifeboat, you will find a respite, a haven from how it is, and a bit of how it was, how it may be again, hopefully. For the next hour, sit back and join us for music, conversation, and everything else. Essentially, everything we've always wanted to do and play and say.
And we couldn't.
And we
let's get dizzy.
Thank you. Nice, Mr. Vern. Nice. Good evening, Jay.
Good evening, Mr. Yardkin.
How are you?
Good evening, folks. Start a little bit late tonight, but not too bad.
No, we had to reboot. One booty came off.
shake.
Shake your booty.
Woo.
Oh, how was your week?
It was good. It was a good week. Yeah.
Did you have any like shaman singers come in to record this week?
No shamans this week.
But, any buffalo heads come in this week?
But I had a few rappers.
Rap. Remember that song, The Rapper? Rap.
Hold on. A little trivia.
Call me the rapper.
A little trivia.
Was that Billy Joe Royal? No.
I want to say that was the Jaggers.
The Jaggers, that's right.
And I met them, and they're from Pittsburgh, and they came into a club I was playing in, and I met the Jaggers, the lead singer.
What year was that?
I met them like 77, maybe.
That
song was about 1971 or two.
Yeah.
I think, yeah, the Jaggers.
I was thinking about songs I grew up with because I had a transistor radio. The little one had a 9-volt battery, but and there was a song, it was a. Was it Fanny Hill from Cherry Hill Park?
Oh, Cherry Hill. I used to bat bomb in Cherry Hill Park. Oh, you're killing me with
wasn't
that.
Wasn't that Billy Joe Royal?
Oh, my gosh. You know,
the lyrics were obscene, man. It's like, give it up for a pack of cigarettes or something horrible, you know? And this what they got away with, was ridiculous.
Yeah, not today.
No, not at all. So, we're glad to be back on the Lifeboat again. After a tough week, this is our haven. You're welcome to join us. We're going to float around a bit for an hour or so. We got jazz and conversation and all kinds of stuff. We have special guests. We have our engineer is Zengineer Scotty. Zengineer Scotty, are you there?
Hello. I am here working on some...
Wait a minute. He's everywhere.
I'm nowhere and everywhere at the same time.
And that's, if you're everywhere, you're ubiquitous.
Oh, that's a good word.
I learned that.
That's a Scrabble 4-syllable winner right there.
I used to be smart before I got in the music business.
I know it. We're going to keep playing until the money runs out. That's what they say.
That's what they say, gentlemen.
And we have a few special things tonight. We have a special guest for our call-in. And you know who that's going to be, Jay?
I heard a rumor that it could be a former bandmate.
An actual bandmate.
Yeah.
But yeah, we used to do a concert series back here. This is Jay's Place Recording, high atop Scenic Music Row.
High atop.
And over the summer, we started doing the jazz drive-in outside so people could drive in and stay in their cars, and we were socially distanced back. And like, we have our sneeze guard here. They have like our sneeze guard. This is good. We're going to set up a salad bar. We're going to talk about salads later. And we were playing out back, and it was great until it started raining every Saturday night. So the jazz drive-in had to morph into this. But the band that we play in is called the Whole Tones. And the drummer for the Whole Tones is our special guest to call in, the legendary Paul Skulton.
Legendary
Paul Skulton. Yes, the Whole Tones is a great band that also involves Sam Hunter and folks like that. And those are Whole Tones, aren't they?
Those are Whole Tones. Mr. Wizard.
Wait a minute. I got the dream sequence. Ancient Chinese secret. So Paul will be our guest, and the Whole Tones is a great band, and we get out and play. When we get out and start playing again, in clubs, we'll be back out. But meanwhile, so the song we just did, "Night in Tunisia," was
a Dizzy Gillespie song.
It's a Dizzy Gillespie song made famous by...
Famouser
by Charlie Parker.
Yeah, Charlie Parker and Dizzy.
Can you get famous?
And I just saw a new documentary on Charlie Parker.
Yeah.
And one of the greatest lines in there was a guy that said, they're still trying to figure out that 4-bar break.
Yeah.
Which is probably the greatest 4 bars.
It's ridiculous. That's why I
in the history of jazz.
He's a...
Yeah.
It's just a fact, and it never misses. I mean,
never.
It's right in the pocket. And to start cold like that is incredible.
Yeah.
You know, and but another one of our favorite.
But that was from Jazz at Massey Hall, which was. That was a recording made at in Canada by Charles Mingus, the bass player, who had a little tape recorder, probably with two mics.
Get out.
And Parker was passed out in his bedroom or something and barely got on stage. And they had to buy him a sax at the drugstore on that show. Man. And it's called the greatest jazz concert ever. World's greatest jazz concert.
The greatest
and,
concert ever.
I told. Wore that album out. That's all the definitive version. You know, Never Be Another You. It's on, Salt Peanuts is on that. And that is also the concert that Bud Powell, the piano player, would not stop playing unless Charles Mingus shined a flashlight in his eyes. He would not stop soloing.
Wow.
Because he was on the way to the, you know, he was mentally, yeah, mentally unbalanced, Bud Powell.
Wow.
It's the greatest record, honest. Two mics, mm-hmm, in mono. On a stage, you know, and it just sounds incredible. Yeah.
Well, awesome. But meanwhile, another, another one of our favorite composer pianists is Ahmad Jamal.
Oh, yeah, he's just.
And Jay and I had the pleasure.
Yes.
Of seeing him live here in Nashville.
In Symphony Hall.
At the Skirmerhorn Symphony Hall. It was the last thing we got to do, February?
Yeah, it was right before the pandemic.
Before the pandemic! And
it literally was the greatest show I ever saw.
It was the greatest show I ever saw.
Yeah, and it was.
And at the Skirmerhorn, they have seating behind the stage where the orchestra is for the choir, when they have a choir.
And those are usually the cheap sheet.
The cheap sheets. And
say that 10 times.
Right, but because you're sitting behind the act who's facing forward. Mm-hmm. So they're cheap. So we got seats there, and it turns out that Ahmad Jamal, who comes out, and he's like 90 years old.
92.
It was amazing. So he just comes sashaying out, you know, and he sits down, and his piano is
facing us.
Thus. You know, like, because he wants to look at the band.
And we're literally 30 feet away from
if
him.
If that. 25 feet away.
And we watched him conduct.
Yeah.
We watched him.
With facial expressions and musical cues. Yeah.
Everything is conducted by him. He's like it's just unbelievable.
So we're gonna do one of our favorite Ahmad Jamal tunes, which is called Biancavo, which loosely translates to good or nice dig. You're like, hey, nice dig, man. So that's the best I can come up with. I was looking for a translation.
I can dig it, man.
I can dig it, man. So let's be in Cabo, Jay. Thank you. the money. Boom, bang. Very nice, Jay. Yes, Ahmad Jamal. And boy, remember the percussionist that he had with him? They had a drummer.
Well, he was from Weather Report.
Was that the dude?
Oh.
He had like the mohawk or something, and he played the weirdest, craziest stuff. I just don't remember his name, but he was great. The band was amazing. Ah. What is that? Judging by the music that Mr. Verne is playing on the Paul Wurley. I've always called a Wurlitzer, his nickname, a Wurley, and it just goes right to Paul Wurley, one of our great producers here in Nashville. The songs are songwriter. This is the writer's block. Songs that make the janitorial staff cry. I write the songs. Our featured writer artist this week.
It's not Barry Manilow.
It ain't Barry Manilow, dude. Nothing wrong with Barry.
Nothing wrong with Barry.
Barry, come in and drink your chocolate milk. In fact, it's Charlie Parker.
It is Charlie Parker.
And one of the greats.
How long can you do a jazz show and not talk about Charlie Parker? Not very long.
Not really.
No, you have to.
One of the great masters. Yeah. There's no sense doing a bio about him because everybody basically knows about Charlie Parker. But,
right.
We're going to get into, you know, his music. You do have some Charlie Parker related info, but we're going to get to that.
Yeah, we're going to do one. It's a little mashup that we came up with in our whole tones day.
Yes. Always peppering with Tower of Power.
Parker squib meets cakes. Power.
Parker squib cakes. Thank you.
two for night.
I'm telling you, that's cleaner than Mr. Clean.
Oh, Charlie Parker.
So you actually?
I was in your neck of the woods, Doylestown, Pennsylvania.
Dude, Doylestown.
Now, where did Washington throw the quarter across the river? Near Doylestown?
No, that was the Delaware. He threw.
That's not near Doylestown.
Well, he crossed the Delaware. Did he? I want to be.
It's all relatively close down there, isn't it?
But pretty much.
Okay.
You know.
But Doylestown is like an antique capital.
Yes, that's west of Philly.
Yeah, and
it could have been the Susquehanna River that he tossed a coin.
Wait, that was Three Mile Island, wasn't it?
Dude, I got a Three Mile Island story for you.
So do I.
Oh,
no. We were driving by it doing a gig in Pennsylvania when that thing went off.
Yeah, we were. My band was in Carlisle, Pennsylvania, Boiling Springs, Pennsylvania, and I didn't go. It's the only job I said, guys, I'm not going.
Wow.
You know, it's melting down, and they went. They went, and to this day, they glow in the dark. you can read your watch.
Wait a minute, remember that watches we had when we were kids and had radium in them?
You know, all the better to see in the dark.
Yes.
You know?
Well, anyways, what were you?
Doylestown.
Oh, yeah. So I had a friend, Kenny Kosicki, if he's watching tonight, which he probably is.
Hey, Kenny.
One of my better best friends from high school. He was playing bass with an Elvis impersonator in Doylestown, Pennsylvania.
Yeah.
And Baird Parker, Charlie Parker's son, was playing guitar at the band. And I got to meet him that night and hang out with him, and it was just incredible.
With an Elvis impersonator.
He was
Parker's son.
Yes.
Do you remember the name of the Elvis impersonator?
I don't. Sadly, I don't. But
because remember in Nashville, there used to be a guy named Velvis.
No, the other one was Orion.
Orion. Oh, he was big time.
World famous.
We had Velvis.
Yeah.
Or was that the vampire Elvis of Velvis? Anyway.
But anyways, that's my little connection to Charlie Parker.
That's your Parker story.
And he's been one of my favorites, of course, like everybody's.
Yeah, incredible. The tortured genius, you know, is always tough to watch. But
the other interesting thing was back in the day of Parker, a lot of these guys took songs and put their own melodies on them. And I thought I knew what that was, but just the other day in research for the show.
In research, yes.
I came across the fact that that is called a contrafact.
The fact is, it's a contrafact. Where you take a popular song, and but you put a different melody to the same changes and the same structure and the same arrangement. Same key, basically.
So in essence, it's a different melody, and but it's the same changes. There's been some famous bebop ones. Whispering was the original song, which became
Groovin' High.
Something like that. Yeah. Ooh, that's been a while.
Yeah, that's a good one.
That's
a
good one.
So it was,
so that was really another song. And that was a common tool. And
contrafact.
I believe the original writer still got paid.
I'm not sure how that works.
I'm not sure how that works.
How did it work with Weird Al Yankovic?
Okay, so that's a parody. And that's interesting because a parody, you don't have to pay the royalties.
Right.
You're allowed to make fun of somebody.
Well,
in music, without having to pay a song.
Wait Weird a minute. Al, man.
Where can we take that?
I mean, my favorite Weird Al was Stop Dragging My Car Around. Stop Dragging It was like a tow truck. You know, Stop Dragging My Car Around.
He drove to fame with Eat It, though.
Oh, Eat It, yeah.
Eat It had to be
and
the best.
Big and fat. You know, he did turn big into fat.
And he's a damn good accordion player, too.
His arrangements were brilliant.
Yeah, was his dad Frankie Yankovic?
I don't know. That's always been a good question. I don't know.
Well, maybe some Frank accordion Yankovic players that we know will tell us.
Was the polka king.
Yeah.
Frankie, he won every polka Grammy. Polka, polka, polka. The birdie, birdie, speedy.
Well, anyways, going back to the contrafact.
Back to the contrafact. So we're one of Charlie Parker's.
We're going
to
play one example of a contrafact.
Of favorite contrafacts was he took How High the Moon, which was a Morgan Lewis song. Very popular song, How High the Moon.
Which we'll play a little bit of that.
Did a contrafact and turned it into ornithology, because he was the bird, you know.
Yeah, right.
It's ornithology. So here's How High the Moon, and it's contrafact, ornithology.
Thank you.
Here we go. Ornithology. That's nice. That's nice. Oh man. Why, judging from the music, the musical clock, I just called to say I love you. Well now, I just called to say I love you. We have a very special call out tonight. As I said, our special guest tonight is the fabulous. Is he? Oh, he's.
Oh, it's you.
Oh, ladies and gentlemen, say hello to Paul Skulton.
Just for you, Paul.
Is Jay there as well?
Jay is here. He
just for you, Paul.
You can't hear him.
Oh, sorry.
we're working our way towards technology.
Yeah.
But right now he can hear you. He can
hear
you.
Hey, Paul. What's up, brother?
Hi, Paul.
It's good to be aboard the. What is this? The lifeboat, right?
Yeah.
This is the lifeboat.
We hope.
Throw you a preserver. The great Paul Skulton, ladies and gentlemen, drummer extraordinaire. As I had mentioned, Paul is the drummer in our jazz group, the Whole Tones. And
I have had the pleasure many times. And yeah, you guys have been plugging yourself, haven't you? These guys are amazing. If you haven't caught the Whole Tones, you are missing out.
You are missing. Paul is also a drummer in a Zeppelin tribute band.
And, yes, I am. I was just on Dazed and Confused when you called.
Oh, I love that song.
Oh, nice. Now, what's the name of that band, Paul? Wow. You guys are remarkably in sync. That was like, you're on a freaking phone and Jay's over here, like, and you guys were perfectly in time. And Paul is also the founder and drummer and producer at County Q Studio
in
Berry Hill, Tennessee, inside Nashville. It's inside the city, is its own city.
City within a city, if you will.
The city's so big you have to leave the limits to change your mind. That's all it is. It's so small the main power plant consists of a Sears Die Hard. But
why don't just sit around the city.
And Paul is you're responsible for so many artists in country music that you trained at Q, people that you chose to sing demos. And I was, you know, of course, watching the inauguration, and out comes Garth Brooks to sing, and I'm thinking, Paul, you made Garth Brooks into what he is.
That's a bit of a stretch.
It's true.
I did work with him when he was $30 a song.
Yeah. $30 a song.
$30 a song will get you Garth Brooks singing your demo. Call him up. See if he'll still do it.
You got his number. Let's just call him up.
He did a fine job. I noticed he turned around after three verses of Amazing Grace, and then about 5 minutes later, he was still working the crowd. And I thought, damn, that's Garth.
Yeah, he did. He pulled off the blue jeans pretty good too. But you know, that's okay.
So we're on Facebook, right? So
yes,
there must be some ground rules determining what subject are taboo.
It's true. But so, who are some of the other names that have come through your doors there over the years?
Well, it's a small town, John, as you know. You were there for a lot of this. I mean, I've known you since I moved here in the mid-80s.
Yes.
We were there back in the high-flying late 80s, early 90s, when a lot of the big-money country names were, you know, in development. Garth Brooks, Alan Jackson, and Brooks and Dunn, and Randy Travis, and Reba, and all of those acts that kind of defined the era of big publishing money in this town were circulating in the 80s, and it all sort of coalesced around the Garth Brooks explosion, because he applied not just hit songs, but full press marketing. I mean, the guy has all the skill set required to be a superstar, not to mention that incredible type A personality. Man, the guy shakes hands everywhere he goes with everyone.
He does.
What does that tell you? Would you do this?
Well, not today, but he's always done that. Yes.
Well, it would
and he,
be.
And he has those big beefy hands too, you know.
Yes,
grabs hold of you, lad. Paul, what's one of the, if you think about it for a second, what's one of the bizarre sessions that came into County Q?
Well, it's easier to name the normal ones than to cherry pick the bizarre ones. I mean, we've had some characters. We had a guy that came in there one time, and he insisted on singing every song in E flat, but he would capo up to F and then detune the guitar to get. I mean, and I said, "Well, why don't you just play it open?" And he said, "Why would I do that?" And this guy, I'm not going to name names.
Of course not.
I mean, we're on. Is this the lamestream media or the regular media?
I'm afraid this is lamestream. This is, yeah, I mean, that's where we prefer to be, I suppose.
So this guy counted off every song on this record, all 12 songs, over the course of the 3 days of tracking with 3, 2, 1, go. 3, 2, 1, go.
3, 2, 1, go.
God, I wish I could name.
And
this guy, he, at any rate, no, we've had a lot of characters, and we like it that way. I mean, I as a kid, I assumed that. Colorful personalities were the exception to the rule, and the older I've gotten, I'm sure you two can attest. the older you get, you realize pretty much everyone's insane.
Yes, it's true.
Music.
Different degrees of insanity.
To do this for a living is insane to begin with, but this business attracts creative types, and to be creative, I think something is given up. When you're that talented, something's got to give, and often
something's got to give.
Oftentimes, it's common sense or just the ability to social skills. You two guys get along with everybody, so you two are like unicorns.
Unicorns, I love it.
Has so, everyone listening seen the Whole Tones live? Is this a Whole Tones commercial or what?
It might be. I've put up some videos that we had done at the Jazz Drive-In last summer. But other than that, the Jazz Drive-In.
COVID didn't stop these guys. They set it up out in the parking lot in the middle of Music Row, packed the place with folks who brought their own drinks and popcorn, sat in their cars and watched 30-minute extended improvisation.
Jam, man.
Yeah, really. Drum solo, 15 minutes. Yeah.
There was a tip jar, sure, but come on, it was basically insane what you guys did all last summer. But why? Because
the music.
You do it no matter what. It's not about making a living, it's about expressing yourself.
No, actually, we had a tip tuba, which was in front of it. It was like a tuba that had been run over by a truck. And if people put tips in it, it would just fall out the hole in the bottom and blow away. So it wasn't about the money.
Are you guys performing in this show at all? Or
yes. Oh, yes. Yes, you can check it out later.
Jazz and conversation.
From the foot of Mount Belzoni.
Where is Mount Belzoni?
I think I looked it up, and I think it was supposed to be near Baton Rouge, but there are no mountains near Baton Rouge.
There's an ocean down there.
It's an over the ocean. It's
swamp.
A Scranton, Pennsylvania. Okay, one small thing is I have a drum head of Paul's that he broke through one time, and I asked him to sign it.
Oh,
and one of our favorite old films comedies is The In-Laws.
Oh yeah,
there was a remake, was terrible, but the original was Alan Arkin and Peter Falk. And Richard Libertini as the Central American dictator. No, you look at what you want to geese. He was insane. But one of the hook lines is that it's over the ocean to Scranton, Pennsylvania. Alan Arkin. And Paul wrote that on the drumhead for me. It's over the ocean to Scranton, Pennsylvania.
You still have this head, do you?
I do. I'm a pack rat. But no, I have that discount coupon from County Q that you made me too, as a matter of fact.
Oh, really? Have you redeemed this yet?
No, I haven't. I don't think there was an expiration date on it anyway.
Really? But, at today's prices, that'll get you a synth solo.
Oh, nice.
Jay, dial up a nice Elka string pad.
Killer.
Jay is playing all black keys right now. You can do this at home.
It's the Whole Tones. Well, Paulie, thanks for joining us on the boat for a little drift about.
I'm gonna dive back into this and be shark bait.
Please do.
This was a pleasure. You guys are amazing. And in all seriousness, people, if you haven't caught the Whole Tones, these guys are amazing.
Thank you, Paul. Amazing.
Have a blast.
Thank you, Paul. World famous Paul Skulton.
Thank you, Paul. Thank you.
Oh, man.
Boy, I love Paul. Great drummer.
He's great. All around. I love the versatility of people like Paul. He's in a Zeppelin band. He produces, countless millions of country demos and masters. And then plays jazz with us.
Yep. Incredible.
Yeah, incredible guys. All right, well, let's see. It's
I think it's time for
it's drinking time.
It is drinking time.
And I'm gonna did you bring a glass? Oh, you didn't bring a glass.
No, I do. Oh. Right here.
Oh, you
do? Right here.
I will do you can live vicariously through my drinking. Here's a toast of Centenario Añejo. L'chaim all.
Happy drinking.
We have a drinking song in the middle, so, and it's a song that's going to have easy lyrics, and you can join us. So when the lyrics roll around, take a drink and join us to sing. And we usually sing about the cold duck. It's cold duck time.
But I thought, you know what? It's time for a new drinking song.
A new drinking?
Yeah, a new one.
Oh, man.
Let's change it up. What?
All right. Here's a new drinking song for tonight. You may remember this. Anybody of age, like me, will remember this drinking song from the early 80s, late 70s, actually, I think.
Yeah.
And it was actually sung by an R&B singer named
Arthur Prysock. Arthur Prysock.
Yeah.
Wow.
So you probably know it. I'll sing it once, and we'll take a drink, and then we'll sing it together again. Here it goes. Here's to good friends. Tonight is kind of special. The beer we pour must mean something more somehow. So tonight, let it be low and brow. Anybody that remembers that, you're definitely past a few years. Cheers.
Cheers.
Tonight.
So now that we've drank, we're going to sing it one more time. Here we go. Here's to good friends. Tonight is kind of special. The beer we pour must be something more somehow. So tonight, let it be low and brown. We're going to start. I think we should start doing a segment of beer commercials, man.
Yes.
We'll get into those.
A little Fernando's Hideaway.
Oh, I'm ahead of the program.
No,
I couldn't resist Hernando, but it's not time for Hernando.
It's not time for Hernando.
So that was just a little tango.
Oh no,
prelude, interface.
We'll come back to Hernando.
This is A minor.
Redenbacher.
That's popcorn.
Orville Redenbacher.
Back when instrumentals used to actually happen on the radio.
Yeah.
But that is the theme for our arrangement on the spot segment. And the arrangement on the spot, we like to talk about the fact that as session players here in Nashville, you are required to get massive amounts of work done in a recording session, and you have to make arrangements on the spot.
Right. You have to have ideas instantly.
Back pocket full of ideas.
Yes. Now you must have them.
Now, in the improvisational world, you have one of the most demanding improvisation, mentally demanding improvisational jobs.
I didn't think about it until the other day, but I play for ballet rehearsals.
For Nashville Ballet.
And most piano players that play ballet bring a book with repertoire, they call it, which is classical music. Although they do enjoy a good tango, occasionally. But mostly classical repertoire, which I do not take the repertoire with me. I just go there and make up songs.
Plié.
Yes.
Releve.
Yes. Releve. Right.
Are these live classes or virtual?
Live classes now. They've been virtual, but they just started coming live again.
So how many dancers are in a class?
Six, and they're 10 feet apart.
10 feet apart.
And they have to wear a mask. So everything's good.
And how long is a class?
An hour and a half.
And it's nonstop, is it?
Right, nonstop. It's very incredible to watch, really. It's all ballet classes all over the world are the same here in Madagascar and Sweden.
What was the line about repetition?
The greatest quote. I sent this to my daughter, Ella, if she's watching. Bob Fosse, who is, you know, one of the greatest of all time.
All that jazz.
And he says, you know, if you don't like repetition, you might be in the wrong business. Because dance is repetition over and over. These kids do these moves, and it's way harder than music, I can tell you right now.
Well, describe how you provide music for the class.
Well, they, like I said, they have things they do at the bar and then in the open floor, and they have grooves that they like.
Right.
Mostly 3/4, and there's some 4/4, and the teacher will give a 20-second explanation, and they turn to me, and I have to come up with something. And so for a tendu, which is a foot exercise, and there's always a couple of beats of preparation.
Okay.
It might be something like this. So, and there's always 8-bar phrases. It's really actually quite easy to improvise classical.
Right.
I mean, classical players are laughing at me right now, but, it's definitely good enough for them to play to dance to, and it's kind of sounds, and it's great for me because I have to come up on the spot arrangement. Yeah. Their big thing is coming across the floor with adagio, which is very expressive, slow. Think the Blue Danube by Strauss.
The Blue Danube.
Yeah. So I'll play something, and that's a little fast, but they like a little slower.
Okay.
So here's one that I made up, I think. I'll make it up now. Anyways, I am very happy to have my instant arrangement every day. I literally do 25 to 30 per class, and I do 7 or 8 classes a week. So I have to invent 200 or 300 songs. There, some of them are quite similar, so it's not hard, but it's tough. But
you're tough.
My session experience has helped me with that
greatly. That's great.
So that's our instant arranging. Find a disco, quick.
I love pizzicato. You know, pizzicato, it sounds like something kind of dirty. You know?
It does.
Oh, is that your pizzicato? But, so that was our arrangement on the spot. Thank you very much.
Yes.
Scotty, do you, Zengineer Scott, do you have any
Zengineer Scotty.
Any experience with ballet dancers?
Let me tell you a story about a ballet dancer.
Please.
Along my spiritual adventures, I met this beautiful ballet dancer who not only spiritually guided me, but mentally calmed me, like the ocean. That's all I know about ballet.
That's all, apparently all you need to know. Thank you.
Thank you.
And
Zengineer Scotty.
Oh, yes.
Ancient Chinese secret. Huh? But my life revolves around old commercials. It's terrible.
Well, I know.
Mamma mia, that's a spicy meatball. Remember that one? Ah, now.
This brings us to our food section.
Hernando's Hideaway.
Which tonight we're going to dub Cheap Eats.
Is it Cheap Eats?
Where to eat cheap in Nashville. Come on now, we're on musician budgets.
We are.
Can you really afford a $15 hamburger? Because I know that I can't.
What is on a $15 hamburger?
About $14 of something.
It ain't caviar, baby. It ain't caviar. Would you put caviar on a hamburger? A hemiar? Yeah. A cav burger?
Well, anyways, Nashville's a great food town. A lot of places are closed, but there's still some great ones.
There was a newspaper column that we used to have here in town.
Yeah, it was called Mrs. Cheap.
Mrs. Cheap.
And I'm going to be Mr. Cheap tonight.
Was that in the scene? Was Mrs. Cheap in the scene or the Tennessean?
She was in both Tennessean and the scene. Yeah, she made it to both, along with News of the Weird.
Oh, I love News of the Weird.
Which was the best.
And the You're So Nashville Awards every year.
Well, that goes without saying. I know. You're So Nashville. But just real quickly, I'll give you my couple of places I think are incredible lunch deals.
Okay.
I've already mentioned Las Americas once, I believe, on the show earlier. But Las Americas is a Salvadoran restaurant on Nolensville Road.
Which part of Nolensville Road? The high or the low?
Down by your end of town, the low end of Antioch area.
Antioch, okay, down there.
And it has Salvadorans feature grilled cheeses. They call them pupusas.
Yes,
pupusas. And they're gigantic. They're $3, and they come with coleslaw and chips and salsa. So for $3, you sit there with this gigantic grilled cheese, like three times bigger than Waffle House.
You know, that'll back you up like the Queensboro Bridge.
Whatever. You got the coleslaw to flush it down.
That's a good one. Okay.
No, honest. You get the coleslaw. You get this is incredible. Oh, $3. Okay. Another one is... another one near one of your houses, Siam Cuisine.
Oh, the Siam Cuisine. That's a great bargain.
It's $7.
Yeah.
For the exact same stuff, it's $25 at night.
Yeah.
And you get the whole lunch with the soup and the egg roll and the
spring
roll.
That place has been there since I've been here. That is like 35 years we've been going to the Siam Cafe.
Yeah. And just my third one will be just a staple, Jack's Barbecue.
You like Jack's?
$6. You get the barbecue sandwich on cornbread, not on the, you don't get it on a roll. Come on. You get it on the cornbread, and they have all these fixings they throw in there. It's like 2 pounds of food for $6.
I'm a sucker for Witz. I really am.
Witz is good.
Driving through Witz, you get them the corn cakes and the barbecue and the beans. It's really good stuff.
All right.
It's a mushky special. Now, I gotta, okay, before we leave the cheap eats, I gotta remind you.
Oh, my gosh.
Of a time, sure, this is probably 10 years ago.
Yeah.
And we would be doing, you know, the all day sessions here.
Right.
And we would take a lunch break, and you would go, one time you gotta go over. There used to be Harris Teeter was a grocery store not far from here. Now it's a Kroger.
Right.
And, you got to go over to the Harris Teeter and
for the $2.99 lunch.
The $2.99 lunch, and it was one of the choices was a crab cake
of real crab, not the fake crab made from fish.
Right. And if you were to buy a crab cake, they were like $9 a piece,
$7, $8,
and you get the lunch special, and you get a crab cake and all this other stuff, and it was like $2.99. And we'd come back here with our little trays, feeling like we'd found, you know, the Holy Grail. Yeah. You know, like
when you beat the system, it feels good.
Oh, it was delicious, and they did that for years.
Oh yeah, we ate that.
Where do you want to go for lunch? I don't know. Let's get a crab cake at Harris Teeter. Yeah. Crazy. Awesome. All right. So, all right. Well, that probably takes care of. Oh, we did that.
Yeah, we did that.
Let's play some music. What do you say? We like Miles Davis, of course. And, interesting. Cicely Tyson just passed.
Yeah.
She was married to Miles Davis, man. Imagine that.
Wow.
You know the Miles Davis story about the first time he met Parker?
No.
It's rough.
Yeah.
It's rough. And he said it was harsh, man. He walked in on Parker during a particularly inconvenient moment. But so Miles Davis, so he wrote this song. This song is called Move. And
it's normally a bit faster.
Breakneck speed. It's usually fast.
It's not called Move for nothing.
It'll part your hair and put a head on your beer. That's how fast it is.
In our whole tone craziness, we decided to make a slow song out of it.
We did.
Take something from church.
Here we go. 2-1. Thank you.
You are correct, Scotty.
It's
Zengineer.
Time for Ask Zengineer Scotty.
Good evening, gentlemen.
Good evening, Scotty.
Scotty, do you have the magic eight ball with you tonight?
Jonathan, it is always with me. Do you have a question you would like me to ask it?
Yes.
Yes, we would like to. Well,
yeah.
Yes, we'll ask the eight ball something, and then we'll ask with you some things, because it's the Ask Scotty segment. Mighty eight ball. Should we buy stock in GameStop?
And the answer is?
The eight ball says.
The eight ball has spoken.
And what does the eight ball say?
Yes.
Oh, man. Oh. That was a major coup, man. They burned the hedge funds, man. That's funny.
They burned the hedges.
They burned the hedges. Stonehenge.
Remember Benson and Hedges?
Yes.
Cigarettes, yes.
Do you remember the commercial?
Yes, send Scotty.
No, Benson and Hedges was
this. They were in the same era of Virginia Slims.
Very skinny and long, yes. Yeah.
Benson and Hedges 100s. I never smoked, so I don't know. But
we used to steal them from my buddy's parents.
Wait, Zen Scott.
Zen Scotty smoked.
That was Target. That was back in my time when I listened to punk rock and dated ballerinas.
Punk rock ballerinas.
Yes.
All right. My question for Zengineer Scott tonight is, what is the ratio of sound that can penetrate a saran wrap sneeze guard?
Well, it depends on what your definition of penetrate is.
Well, we're lamestream social media, so we can say penetrate.
So in that case, yes, if you're talking about audio waves or spit passing through, I've done massive and extensive research on your sneeze guard that you've concocted, sir. And I believe that it is 99.9% effective.
Can we say concocted?
We can censor it later.
Okay.
I'm going to bring it down to more real to earth, Scotty, for you.
Please, yes.
Zengineer Scotty.
What do you got?
If you were to leave your house in Boca Raton and go into the water of the Atlantic Ocean, would you ever come back?
Wow.
That's a tough one, isn't it?
I'll have to meditate on that later, but I can neither say yes nor no, Jay, at this point in time. Let me ask the Magic 8-Ball.
Well, we'll go ahead. Just bring us the Magic 8-Ball. What does the Magic 8-Ball say?
Says... Reply hazy. Ask again later.
Oh.
The reply is hazy.
I like replay hazy.
Me too.
Do we know hazy?
Oh, I don't know.
that's spooky, not
that's
hazy.
Spooky. I like it though. It's the cool of the evening
when everything acting kind of hazy. Okay, we're gonna rewrite that song. We'll do a parody.
Hey, yeah.
Let's do a.
It won't cost us anything.
Let's do a contrafact.
Do a contrafact.
Yeah,
yeah.
That'd be great. All right, let's play some tunage. What do you say?
Oh, I think we are approaching our theme.
Our theme. Isn't this a Horace Silver number?
I don't know who wrote this.
Oh. Once again, thank you for joining us on a Sunday evening for a bit of a floatabout here on the Lifeboat. I hope you've found it to be a good distraction. That's why we're here. Join us every Sunday night. Pull up a seat, move an oar, cast a yardarm, hoist a grog. We'll be here with you. You can join us. Sing along. Here we go from the top.
Show me the way to go home. I'm tired and I want to go to bed. I had a little drink about an hour ago.
Well, maybe a half hour.
And it's gone straight to my head.
What's left of it?
Everywhere that I roam, over land, sea, or foam, you can always hear me singing a song. Show me the way to go home.
Good night, folks.
We're clear.